We're all familiar with the different forms of H2O. Water, ice, steam. But do we think about the incredible changes that are taking place? How do we get from these three forms of water to things like snowflakes, clouds, or even waves? Let's examine some basic substances and learn to see the world as a chemist. This is Real Chem. I want us to think about how we classify matter in chemistry. Getting the vocabulary right at the outset is very important. Sometimes when learning new material, a crucial first step is learning to communicate with precision. Once we have this down, the rest gets a little easier. Let's begin by examining the simplest form of matter, elements. Picture a container filled with single balls. Each ball represents an individual atom of, let's say, argon. These atoms are identical, forming a pure substance known as an element. Now, let's have a look at another element, hydrogen. Two hydrogen atoms can bond together to form hydrogen gas, a molecule. Despite being composed of molecules, hydrogen gas remains an element because all of its particles are made up of only one type of atom. So what happens when atoms of different elements combine to form new substances? Consider a container filled with triplet balls, with one red and two white balls, representing water molecules. These molecules consist of hydrogen and oxygen atoms bonded together. This creates a compound, which is a substance made up of at least two different types of atoms. But it is still a pure substance because each molecule is the same. Finally, when different substances are physically combined without forming new chemical bonds, a mixture is formed. And unlike elements and compounds, mixtures retain the individual properties of their components, and it is not a pure substance anymore. So, these substances will be able to take different forms depending on temperature. The way these nanoscopic particles are arranged in their different states can explain their properties, what we see and experience at our macroscopic scale. In a solid, the particles are fixed in place and can only vibrate about these fixed positions. This explains why solids can't change shape or flow. If you increase the temperature, a liquid can be formed. The particles will start to have enough energy to free themselves from the fixed positions of a solid and start rolling on top of each other, just like in a ball pit. This in turn can explain why liquids can flow and take the shape of their container. Now, if we keep on increasing the temperature, the particles now have enough energy to fly away from each other, forming a gas. A gas can flow like a liquid, but unlike a liquid, they will explore the entire container they are in. In addition, the large space between the particles means that they can be compressed much more easily than either a solid or a liquid. So, the states of matter actually matter, and how we categorize them is important. Chemists have to get their terminology right from the outset. So next time you are marveling at the snowflake or an ice crystal on your windshield, think about what is going on at the atomic scale too. It is just as beautiful. So explore and remember to have fun.